In today's video, we will be taking a look at the best electric bikes you can buy this year. And as usual, we have the links to all the e-bikes mentioned in the description below. And make sure you like and subscribe for more videos like this. Now, let's go straight to the video. Number 5. Okapi Starter Edition E-Bikes. Okapi, a Boston-based startup, produces a unique e-bike that bridges the gap between motorcycle and commuter bike. The bike's dual suspension, headlight, and horn all scream dirt bikes, but the pedals and skinny tires will have you cruising in the bike lane without hassle. These aren't normal bikes. If the futuristic appearance doesn't give it away, the Okapi bikes have an all-electric range of up to 40 miles and a top speed of around 30 miles per hour. Those aren't crazy numbers, but they are more than adequate for a commuter bike. The company is selling its bike for just under $3,000. That's in line with other e-bikes pricing, but Okapi's looks more upscale and refined than the others, which try to look like normal bicycles. The bike's full suspension, hidden storage, and 1,000-watt motor all add up to what appears to be one heck of a fun ride. Forget commuting, electric bikes are just hilarious to ride and are a total riot on the trails. Okapi's design appears to be more robust and able to handle the bumps more than many other electric bikes, some of which appear to be molded after vintage models. The main downside to Okapi's design is the 280-pound maximum weight capacity, which may limit some riders' ability to enjoy the bike. Electric bikes are getting cheaper almost every day, but Okapi's product is priced on the premium end of the spectrum. The Starter Edition bike costs $2,989.98. The good news is the Okapi's bike looks more upscale and robust than many offerings on the market today. Number 4. GoCycle GX. The GoCycle GX is our top recommendation for anyone who wants an e-bike. That's because the GoCycle is more fun to ride and feels more sturdy. The flip side is that it doesn't fold up anywhere near as neatly as the Brompton, but crucially, it folds up enough and sufficiently quickly to legally take it on public transport, although people may tut at you. With 3 gears, variable assistance, you can change when and to what extent it kicks in via GoCycle's handy app, which also lets your phone serve as a basic bike computer. And smallish but chunky sporty wheels, the GX is just a blast to ride. GoCycle's power delivery algorithms and torque sensors have been tweaked by the former F1 engineers, so the ride is one of the smoothest around. It's nippy, maneuverable, and fun, and it also feels more like a proper bike than the Brompton. Lighting is taken care of via a super bright front LED light bar and rear lamp that draw power from the main battery system. So you don't have to rummage around for AAA batteries or remember to plug them into a USB cable to charge. Number 3. Brompton Electric. The e-Brompton is seriously impressive. If your daily commute includes public transport followed by cycling, it offers total ease of parking, can be more easily stowed in a luggage rack than the GX, and still allows you to arrive in a pristine and unsweaty state thanks to the electric assistance. The F1-trained engineers at William Advanced Engineering assisted with the electrical parts, and the result is a 250-watt motor that provides pedal assistance via the front hub, which is still a very unusual approach. It draws power from a 300-watt-hour battery pack that sits in a bag and goes on the front where the Brompton luggage rack would normally sit. You can also opt for a larger bag that holds both the battery and your spare suit or laptop or whatever. Brompton is fun to ride in urban settings, although admittedly not as much so as the GX. It's powerful enough to breeze up the hills with minimum effort, but feels nimble on the flat. As with any Brompton, you probably won't win a half-mile sprint on it, but thanks to the pedal assistance, you most certainly will get off to a flying start. The reason it stands above other electric bikes is that the Brompton has worked out how to apply power assistance to your pedaling so it feels natural. It also doesn't feel so much like it's trying to fight you once you reach the maximum 15.5 miles per hour assisted speed. A neat smartphone app shows current charge levels and lets you tailor assistance setting, while cadence and torque sensors mean power delivery is smooth and only kicks in when truly required. Brompton also plans to offer diagnostics and warnings that a service or battery replacement may be necessary via the app. Brompton offers fewer options than it does with its standard steeds. But while it comes in any color you like, so long as that's black or white, there are also a choice of 2 or 6 gears, that 20-liter bonus luggage option, and you can shell out extra for a fast charging system that delivers an 80% battery top-up in just 90 minutes. The electric Brompton folds up exactly the same as a non-powered Brompton. It's so simple, and unlike certain folding bikes we could mention, what you're left with is a genuinely small thing, rather than something that's about the size of a bike with a front wheel taken off. However, the extra weight of the electric drivetrain means you can't just lug it about with the ease of a standard Brompton. It's not bad at all as you wheel it about on the flat. It has small, suitcase-style additional wheels that come into play once folded up. However, if your commute involves, for instance, having to cross over a bridge to get to a railway platform, you will not enjoy the experience. That aside, the only problems with the electric Brompton are the same as with the standard one. It's pricey. And you do look a bit of a tit riding one, but you'll get over it. Number 2. G-Tech E-Bike City. The G-Tech City bike is way cheaper and simpler than most of the bikes here. And despite being years old, it's still the best cheap e-bike you can buy and ideal for beginners or those on a budget. There are definitely more powerful electric bikes out there than this and a few cheaper ones, but G-Tech, best known for its vacuum cleaners and hedge trimmers, has pulled off a surprise winner with this. For just shy of a grand, you get an e-bike that actually looks like a bike, has a 30-mile maximum range, and is shorn of anything that could be described as complex. You turn it on by pressing the green button on the battery once for low power and twice for high. Although, to be honest, there is not a lot of difference between them. After that, you just pedal. There are no gears, no chain to muck up your trousers, and not that much of a difference in feeling compared to riding a normal bike. The twist is that a computer monitors how hard you have to work to pedal and applies the electric motor as required, so you mainly feel it's a helping hand as you pull away from lights, coming onto corners, and of course, going up slopes. As with all these bikes, the assisted speed is capped at 15 miles per hour, but unlike some of them, the G-Tech E-Bike City or its identical sibling, the E-Bike Sport, is light and agile enough for you to be able to pedal harder without feeling like the weight is fighting you back down to 15 miles per hour. You can even, at a push, use it without the motor on flatter roads. We wouldn't try to take this up on a mountain section of the Tour de France, but the urban hills and more gentle rural inclines, it really does take the work out of it. For the money, and especially considering it comes from a hedge trimmer brand, the e-bike is a great little set of wheels. There have been sacrifices made in the comfort of the saddle and the grips, and the brakes could have a bit more bite to them, but these seem like acceptable compromises to us. In some ways, its real USP at launch was that it looks just like a bike. Thankfully, other brands are now following G-Tech's lead in this area. Number 1. VanMoof S3. The S3 is a very sturdily built thing that rides extremely well. You can get up to 20 miles per hour on the flat with minimal effort, and it irons out hills a treat. Hydraulic disc brakes bring it to a dead stop. Aside from crashes, the biggest worry about riding an e-bike in our crime-ridden cities is the ever-present threat of theft. To fight back against that, VanMoof S3 includes an integral magnetic lock, very hard to remove, an integral alarm, and a GPS tracker that can be used to locate it if anybody is foolhardy enough to steal the bike. Even more remarkable, Van Moof will then send someone to find your bike and politely ask the nice man to give it back. The four auto-shifting gears of the S3 are a big improvement over the S2 that only had two, and they shifted in a way that was often hugely irritating. The only issue I have with this bike is that nobody needs a four-gear hub to shift up and down on its own, and it's one more thing to potentially go wrong. Thankfully, Van Moof bikes are extremely well made, and so I am going to hope that it doesn't become an issue long term. For urban commuting, 21st century style, it's impossible to beat the Van Moof S3 unless your commute demands a folding bike. Thanks for watching, and make sure you click the subscribe button below.